think it's like you see the spot and it looks pretty easy and you think of all these tricks and you get there and it's so hard for various reasons, like the crack and the grate. The first time I got a trick on it and did a backtail front shove, I felt like it should have been really easy because I know how to shove that trick out. But I just like couldn't get into a comfortable backtail because of the grate. I saw a vicious cycle when I was in 7th grade. My favorite clip there from that video was Brian Brown's line, ollie down the stairs, backtail, back nose grind. Zered has insane tricks there though.
I remember going with the Fibro guys to skate there for I think the first time, because they had a Fibro video premiere like down the street. I remember doing like nose slide big spin on it when I was, I think, one of my first times in the city. And see it and fulfill the dream, that was one of my favorite videos. So to skate there was pretty like, felt like surreal almost, you know? Remember skating with Lou, Lurker Lou, kickflip front tail slid it, which was crazy back then. And then I feel like the last time I skated it was with Kalis and Eli, and Kalis did the big spin back tail, which I guess he had tried multiple times. So I was hyped to see that go down live, and then Eli did switch shove crook the same day.
You know, like the big spin back tail days, we wouldn't even really get kicked out, you know? But in the Sixth Sense days, the security guards are constantly coming out talking shit.
So Josh Kalis would stay at my house every weekend and come down here and just destroy the spot. Like, he probably filmed 4 tricks a day at this spot, just like annihilating it. When it was a hot spot, like after Josh's footage came out, we would come here every weekend and see multiple teams like just lined up here rifling tricks. There'd be like a team on this ledge skating and then someone skating over here. It was just like a skate park on the weekends. It was pretty funny. And then we also saw it immortalized in Tony Hawk Pro Skater. It was one of the locations.
All right, welcome to the famous pyramid ledges. Let's rip them up.
My favorite trick I've seen in a video go down that I didn't film was Gino Iannucci's infamous line where he starts up the top over there, does a nollie heel flip, the Jizz's music comes on, he goes through this little tunnel, and it's just like so magical to open up his part, and it's Gino skating to the Jizz.
Oh, Gino skates hard.
He actually had a different trick in mind, the nollie 180 to switch 5-0 that he did later for the hot chocolate video. He like landed on it, came really close. And then I think he filmed that line of just like wanted to get something. And that was like a really good trick for the time, obviously. Like he like filmed it like years later and it was still good, you know. We did like a quick 4-star trip out here and that was the first day I seen Jake Johnson ever skate. Or I don't know if I even knew who he was. Yeah. He was trying switch flip, backside nose grind. I couldn't believe like how good, like, I was just like, who is this dude? Like, you want to skate for 4-star? You want to like, whatever you want. Like, let's get this dude on something. You know, I think he was on riding alien boards at the time, I think. But it was, I remember seeing him there and being like really impressed with like, just how fast he'd go, he'd get on top. Like, it wasn't even like a crooked grind. He was just like stomping it, going so quick. So that was like my introduction to Jake Johnson. It was like super like, pretty impactful. Like,
all I know is like, I think the best looking ledges on the planet, you know? I always looked at Pyramid as kind of like a Hubba hideout where it's, you know, or like a love fountain, you know what I mean? Where it was something where you kind of make your mark and get put in the books, you know? That's one of the things I always thought was important about that spot.